So here's an impromptu video idea I came up with. Basically talking about the series What If. And if you're not aware What If is, it's one of those TV shows, series that premiered on Disney Plus during Phase 4. And it's basically an anthology series of sorts, taking advantage of like the whole multiverse thing that got introduced during Phase 4 when the multiverse was starting to become a new thing in the MCU. And it's basically an anthology following just different paths or universes that the characters could have taken. That's basically it. It's not bad, but it's a very, for most, compared to like most of Phase 4, which has its ups and downs, it's like one of its meh kind of things, which it could have had more potential, be interesting. But a lot of it, especially the first season, was just kind of very, for me at least, very lucrative meh kind of episodes. I mean, you have, my favorites were like the murder mystery one, the zombie one, and the one with Tony and Killmonger. Those were probably my three favorite episodes out of the first season. The rest I don't really remember that well. But yeah, that being said, I bring that up because today, since season 2 got delayed for next year, and there are rumors that season 3 will be its last season, because I guess it's not doing as well as they hoped, I decided, hey, before season 2 premieres, or season 3 goes into development, or whatever's going on there, how about I bring up some suggestions or ideas for episodes that I'd like to see. Probably not in season 2, because season 2 is probably already done at this point, or halfway done, we just gotta wait for it to premiere. But maybe more for like ideas for the third season, if it is gonna be its last, and these are the last opportunity it's gonna get to do these kind of episode ideas. Sorry, I lost my train of thought. Here we go. So, let's talk about some ideas I have. There are gonna be some for Phase 4 and a little bit of Phase 5, because it depends on when Season 3 ever premieres. I assume, like, it seems like they're gonna release seasons 1 year and then wait another whole year and then next year after that. So Season 3 might hypothetically release somewhere in 2026 or 27 if they do it. So here are some of my episode suggestions. I wrote them down because I know I would forget some of them. Okay, so, and if you hear any like paper, that's me reading through my notes that I wrote them down in, so sorry. So the first one I wrote down is, one, what if Thanos invaded sooner? So basically what this one I have in mind is, it's basically like the typical, oh, what if he showed up with the Chitauri, or maybe shortly after the Chitauri, in the first Avengers film in 2012. Now, I know timeline-wise that wouldn't make sense because, oh, wasn't he still collecting the Infinity Stones, or started collecting them at that point? Like, he didn't have them all? Well, it's the multiverse, so this universe's Thanos could maybe hypothetically already have them all at this point. I don't think there really needs to be a full explanation of how he got them all at that point. He could just have them and just already be invading. Since in the post-credits scene for that movie, we can see that he had this planned for a long time, so it's just things being moved up, and he got things done much earlier than he probably expected. So he shows up. I don't know whether it should be with the Chitauri or after, or maybe he should just take the place of them. But in any case, it happens in 2012, and he has to fight the 2012 version of the Avengers, which, as we know, is only like the main six and some people from S.H.I.E.L.D., so not a lot of superheroes at that point to fight him. So maybe halfway through, maybe they could be defeated, maybe they straight up get killed, who knows. One route they can go with that episode is maybe they just get killed immediately, and like maybe it becomes like a villain team up, like a lot of the Marvel villains we would know later on have to team up and take them down. Or maybe another route they could go is he doesn't kill them, but they get defeated easily, so they have to like maybe regroup, maybe they have to join forces with like some people from Hydra or something to be like, hey, we gotta like make a temporary alliance to like beat this giant purple dude from space or something. I don't know, just something like that. When I give these suggestions, you guys can say in the comments how you would like these kind of episodes to go, but yeah, that's basically my idea for that episode. That's all I have to say on that. And let's go to number two. Number two I wrote down is What If Hera Won? So if you guys aren't familiar, this is more of a what if set in phase four, which is in Moon Knight, which if you've seen Moon Knight and how that ends, it's a very abrupt ending. But basically, like, what if when, you know, Mark/Steven fought Hera and that giant kaiju battle took place with her two avatar gods, what if Hera managed to get the upper hand and win in that scenario? I don't know if he'd like straight up just kill Mark, or just like make him unable to fight him again or whatever, but in that scenario he wins the fight and he's able to continue his plan of carrying out I'm sorry, I do not remember the name of the name right now, but he carries out their will of continuing to pass judgment on people who deserve it. And then maybe if Mark is left alive, maybe he has to go and look for the Avengers, or like any remaining Avengers, and like ask them for help, and they like team up and have to like fight him and his giant kaiju crocodile monster that can, I don't know, like maybe that can happen. Or maybe it becomes like one of those bleaker type episodes, like the What If Ultron 1 episode, where like it's just a montage of him continually winning and taking over and just defeating everyone in his path. I don't know, maybe something like that. Number three, what if Hank got stuck in the quantum realm? So this is a very average, I feel like more, like one of the more realistic kind of what ifs I can see happening within that series, since most of their what ifs seem to just be, what if we just switch characters' places? But it's basically, what if Hank took Janet's place, and like he shrunk down so small that he got caught in the quantum realm? Like, what would happen there? How would he react? What would he do, since he is the more scientific one and more the builder there out of the two of them? So like, how would he react? What would he do? How would he survive in that city? Like, what is, you know, MOB there? The whole episode could just be us following him throughout the years. Or maybe it could be like a mix of we cut to him and then maybe we cut back to Janet, who Jenny and Hope, but like, how would they react? Like, how, like, would they try to get him out? Could Jenny like try and find a way to get him out? And if, like, I don't know, like, what would happen there? Maybe you can go back and forth with them, and kind of like a simultaneous plot lines going on. And would the whole, and also would the whole plot of the any of the Ant-Man would even happen? Because I don't think Jenny would just willingly hand over the Ant suit. And if she found out it got stolen, probably wouldn't be cool with it. Like, by someone like Scott, you know? Like, what would happen there? How would it go differently if it was her in Hank's place, you know? Number four is a what if to a more, the most recent entry in Phase 5. So this is more like a hypothetical in Season 3, but this probably won't happen. What if Hope and Scott got stuck in the Quantum Realm? So this is basically a spoiler, and I don't know, not really a spoiler for Ant-Man Quantumania, but at the end when they're fighting Kang and stuff, when they're fighting Kang and stuff, maybe when the portal closes on them, Cassie's unable to open it and they're just kind of stuck there now. Like, what are they gonna do now? Like, how are they gonna survive? Are they gonna join up with like the resistance people they help save? Like, maybe join them? How are Cassie, Hank, and Janet gonna react? What are they gonna do? You know, I don't really have a lot of thoughts in this one. I just thought it'd be interesting to write down since I still have that movie fresh. So the fifth one is, what if Namor revealed himself sooner? I feel like this is a what if scenario or hypothetical I've probably heard somewhere before, but this is basically, oh, what if, like, let's say in Endgame when, or in Infinity War, when people just started vanishing, like the half, like people turning into dust, like that must have affected him too in some way. So like, what if we show that that did affect him, and like he thinks that the surface world has something to do with it directly, and that makes him, and in this universe he gets extra pissed off at that, and that's what makes him finally come to the surface world and maybe threaten them, and then like maybe the remaining Avengers gotta deal with that, and it's like, or maybe something else causes it, I don't know, but that's probably like the more leading thing, something I'm leaning into more, the events of Infinity War and Endgame causing him to come out of the ocean onto the surface world. That's number six is one I'm actually pretty proud of, and I think would be really interesting. And it's, what if Black Widow never turned good? So we all know her backstory with like the Red Room and the Black Widows and stuff. And, you know, it's always alluded to that like she became good after encountering Hawkeye in Budapest. That's mentioned in the first Avengers movie. So in this scenario, what if instead of accepting that chance to redeem herself in Budapest, what if, like, she was just, this version of Natasha was just, like, totally in the, into the, like, just totally believed in the ideals of the Red Room and the Black Widows and everything, and, like, didn't accept his offer, probably killed him immediately first chance she got, and continued to just basically become, like, a villain, and maybe even later on become, like, a major threat for S.H.I.E.L.D. and, like, any Avengers who join after that. Like, we get to see her be like a super cool assassin spy and stuff, but for evil, like the wrong team side. So it's like, how would that turn out? No? Maybe we can get like appearances from like Yelena and stuff too in that episode, or I don't know. Something like that. The number 7 I came up with is not... I think if you guys watch Nando V movies, then you have probably heard him suggest this one, but I really liked it, so I want to kind of expand on that more. But number 7 is, what if the hex kept spreading? So basically, in WandaVision, instead of like getting through to her, or like finally breaking that hex, what if like she manages to keep living in the hex, and Wanda just somehow kept like unintentionally expanding it, and she just kept making it grow bigger and bigger? Like, maybe it starts hitting major cities. Maybe it starts hitting places that the disassembled Avengers are living in. And this could be a serious episode, but this could also be like a kind of jokey episode if you wanted it to be. Like, when you cut to like various other characters or Avengers, you can maybe have them like parodying, like making parodies of like certain genres. Like, for example, if the hex hits Bucky and Sam, wherever they are, maybe you could do like parodies of like buddy cop movies or shows and stuff like that. And maybe if it hits Doctor Strange, it could make like a parody of like medical dramas, you know, those kind of shows. Or who else? Trying to think what other parodies that could be done. A funny one that makes no sense, but I just thought of right now, maybe if it hits Clint, since he lives on a farm, it could be like a Western kind of parody. That probably doesn't make any sense, but it's just a funny thing I came up with right now. But, you know, just something like that. Doesn't really have to make a lot of sense. Just maybe this could be like a funnier episode if you want it to be. You know. Number 8 is, what if Ultron was good? And, you know, despite the name of this one, it's not really Ultron-centric. I wouldn't imagine this one being Ultron-centric, more Tony-centric. Where it's basically... Oh, since the events of Age of Ultron, the movie, never happened, and Ultron, from the start, is built to do what he was supposed to do, and that is just be a protector, like, good for humanity, protect humanity, and stuff like that. What if, like, that, you know, because, what if that, like, immediately goes to, like, Tony's head, and, like, oh, I created the perfect machine to protect us, like, why would we even need the Avengers now, or like all this other stuff, like, why would we even need police at this point, you know, like, why would we need the authority, you know, like, maybe it starts going to his head and he starts building armies of Ultrons, and when people try to talk him out of it, like, tell him that this is like, he's going, like, crazy. He just, like, starts showing signs. Like, he's slowly becoming, like, just even more full of himself than usual. Maybe he becomes full-on drunk with power. And maybe this can become, like, the closest thing we get to, like, a superior Iron Man story in, like, this Marvel Cinematic Universe. Like, maybe that could be, like, a reference to that, you know? A superior Iron Man kind of thing going on. But yeah, that's how I more imagine that kind of episode going. Number 9, again, is another suggestion I saw thrown around a lot, but I liked it, so I'm going to include it here, is, what if Spider-Man was on Cap's team? And the title is very self-explanatory. It's basically just, oh, what if Civil War, but instead of Tony, maybe Steve got to him first, or like, maybe he sought out Steve or something like that, and he just joined his side instead. And maybe we see how Peter's dynamic with like certain members of Team Cap would be, what his relationship with Steve himself would be. Like, would they also have, like, a very mentor-y kind of dynamic? Would it be, it'd probably be, it'd be different, but, like, how would it, like, go? Like, would it have, like, an, like, also, like, a kind of father-son, like, surrogate father-son kind of relation going on? Would he be there when Steve and Bucky fight Tony at the, was it the rat? I don't remember where the, but you know, would he be there during that fight? Because he's just so, like maybe that dedication he has for Tony would be on Steve. So like maybe he'd go with him and help, you know, like what would that be? Like, what would their dynamic be? Like, what would the relation, like, what would happen after that also if he was, and maybe like to make it fair, instead of being on Cap's team, we make Scott Ant-Man on Iron Man's team to, like, make it fair with like numbers. I don't know, maybe you could do that, who knows. Number 10, another one I seen suggested a lot, what if Pietro lived, and this is like a very typical idea that I think honestly should be done, can be interesting, and it's basically, what if at the end of Age of Ultron, instead of being like shot by like 20 bullets, he somehow avoids getting shot and like lives, and basically, I mean, I don't know if like he lives and like Clint dies instead. Ideally, I would want this to go like they both survive, because I loved their banter and just the dynamic they had of like always being sarcastic towards each other. But yeah. So basically, this episode would just be, oh, what if he survived? And how would the rest of the events in like the Marvel Cinematic Universe go if like he was alive, basically? Like would Wanda and Vision even have like their whole romantic thing going on? Because like if Pietro was alive, maybe she wouldn't need to like find comfort in Vision. Like she'd still have her brother, or maybe like they'd still have like that romantic thing going on, but because he's so overprotective of her, he like kind of keeps her from like interacting, or maybe he like smothers her and like keeps her from really forming any friendship or like relationship with anyone else on the team, or like, and maybe you could explore that, and maybe that creates the rift in like their bond, and she starts feeling like smothered by him. I don't know, you could explore that maybe. Like, would also, would the, you know, like how she would want space or something, or I don't know, and maybe, and like, would the events of Civil War even take place if he was there? And if they did, would, and like if the stuff in Civil War went, even if they did stay the same, would we get like, how would like he fight in the airport fight scene? Like, would we get like a cool Quicksilver versus Vision fight? Like all that rage against him like being let out? I don't know. Could be cool. Would we get Aaron Taylor Johnson back to voice him? Or would we just get like a sound alike or someone who could do like an impression? Maybe. But still be cool to see the original one in animated version. That's for sure. And also Infinity War and Endgame. Like, what would happen there? Would he survive the snap and help the Avengers on their time heist? That also probably would be cool. How would the final fight scene go? Who knows, you know? Okay, now let's get to the very last one, which is number 11. What if the other half was snapped? Again, a common one people suggest, but I'm gonna include it here because I like it. So basically, we all know Infinity War, the people who got snapped are like the more magic-based people, you know, like Wanda, Doctor Strange, half of the Guardians, you know. But in this situation, it's more of like the main powerhouses that get snapped away. So you have Tony, Steve, Carol. Instead of a majority of the Guardians, maybe it's just Nebula and Rocket that gets snapped away. You know, like, and stuff like that. And we have to see, like, how would the other half react to this loss? Like, what would they do? Would they also come up with the idea of a time heist? Or would they try and get them back differently? You know, like, how would things go? You know, like, that kind of scenario. So yeah, that's basically all of my suggestion for possible what if episodes to do in the future, in season 2 or 3, maybe. Tell me in the comments, if you're watching this, what your ideal what if episodes would be. And if you liked any of the ones I suggested, how would you imagine them going, or the plot being, you know? So yeah, that's it. This has been just some fangirl. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe.